This lady's making one of my favorite foods ever.
Oh,
it's like a dream.
The average American eats over 35 pounds of cheese per year. That number, in many parts of Asia, is much, much less.
His body was made by cheese.
It still fits, somehow.
What fits?
Cheese making is simply not a generations-old tradition here. But there's one company.
We're getting down to cheesy business over here.
Who's planning to change all that.
I cannot tell you how satisfying it is to put my hands into this hot, melty mozzarella.
In this exclusive series, we're digging deep into food factories that are mass-producing the affordable and convenient products we all take for granted.
Here, the five cheese pizza, all cheeses that they make in their factory. And you have never had blue cheese.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
For today's mission, I'm heading to a hidden location in central Vietnam, where a skilled, passionate team is hard at work.
Oh, every time it's like magic.
This place is a cheese lover's dream.
You guys never let people take a bath in the milk, right?
Here, we'll find out how they make fresh cheese.
It's almost 8 p.m.
From scratch.
Your cheese making process goes overnight.
On a massive scale.
Why do you do that?
Why we do that?
Let's find out.
One, two, three. Are we ready? Ready?
Ready. Ready.
Okay, we're doing it. Oh, should we drink? Yeah, let's start with drinking.
Meet Masuko and Sane. This Japanese couple is introducing food that's traditionally Italian to a Vietnamese crowd at this restaurant, known as Pizza for Peace.
So you can actually make alcohol from a dairy byproduct?
Mm.
When I was in Uzbekistan, I drank alcohol made from horse milk.
Wow.
Horse milk?
Fermented horse milk.
This is something I absolutely love right here. It's the only place in the world I found this type of creation. Is this your creation, one of you?
Co-creation.
Yes. Good.
Cheese has only recently become an emerging trend in this country. But the stuff that's used to top oysters or that's spread on grilled rice paper is highly processed. But here, they've got the good stuff.
I love all kind of cheese, either like a little bit skinny.
I feel like that was aimed at me somehow.
By my side, Han. She'll accompany me on this cheesy adventure.
It's camembert with some truffle infused in this kind of cream inside.
This is our appetizer, truffle camembert. A mix of mascarpone, ground roasted almonds, salt, pepper, and white truffle oil is sandwiched between two layers of camembert cheese.
Grab a piece of cheese. I just put it on the bread.
Perfect.
Oh, okay.
In the past, a meal like this would have only been possible if the cheese was imported from faraway lands. That's why these two created their own cheese factory. Within 30 days, the camembert goes through three main steps. Curdling. Processing the curd. Then ripening and aging, going from fresh cow milk to a French-inspired, distinctive, soft, creamy cheese. From the factory, it's shipped to the restaurant, and under the skillful hands of the head chef,
cheers.
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 It becomes a type of edible art.
Oh my God. It's rich, it's creamy, and then there's just the perfect infusion of truffle flavor in there. It's better than sex. I love it so much. How long ago did you come to Vietnam?
We came in 2009.
When you started, did you start with the restaurant or with the factory? It's like a bird and egg situation. You need the factory for the restaurant, right?
We really started from the pizza.
Masuko is a self-described pizza maniac. He's traveled all over the world to train his taste buds and satisfy his pizza cravings.
When we started, we didn't know anything how to make a cheese. So we wrote a letter to cheese craftsman to come to Vietnam as a consultant. But nobody replied. Then we gave up and we went to YouTube.
Yeah, probably a lot cheaper. Oh my God.
From learning to make cheese from YouTube to running over 25 Pizza 4P's locations, these two have come a long way in a short time. And much of that success is thanks to the cheese.
Your first restaurant was in Ho Chi Minh City.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, your factory now is a 6-hour drive away from here in Dalat. Why is it so far away?
The quality of the milk is much better in Dalat than Ho Chi Minh because of the climate.
The travel time from the milk farm to the cheese factory as short as possible is a much better quality for the cheese.
Mm-hmm. Their cheesemaking headquarters was built in 2011 in Vietnam's temperate central highlands. On the inside, a cheesemaking hub where over 1,300 gallons of milk are turned into over 1,000 pounds of cheese each day.
Right now, we're outside of your cheese factory. Big handshake, or do you prefer a bow?
I prefer bow.
There we go. I didn't go deep enough. That's super respect right here. It's almost 8 p.m. and your cheese making process goes from about 8 p.m. to 8 a.m. Why do you do that?
We wanted to have the cheese as fresh as possible.
Behind their commitment to freshness is a team of 30 cheese makers.
We process in night. Then from the morning, we can start to actually produce. Then we can ship in afternoon. Then in the morning, we can receive and serve in the lunchtime.
That's insane. That's wild.
Here, they're producing over 10 different types of cheeses like camembert, fresh mozzarella, burrata, and string cheese. Right now, they're making ricotta, an unripened Italian cheese. The milk is boiled until it reaches 194 degrees.
So what is the big difference between two-day-old cheese and two-week-old cheese?
Add salt, then whipping cream, then lime juice.
If we don't put preservative, after 5 days, its texture is more softer, then taste is going to get bitter.
That mixture is cooked until it separates into clumps of milky white curd.
So you don't put any preservatives here?
We don't.
Then it's drained.
We want to avoid like anything that's not natural.
And packaged.
I don't even know if your customers appreciate how fresh the cheese is, because that's really a wild commitment to freshness.
Yes.
Does that just come natural to you?
This is what we are committing since we started from the beginning.
So this is the appetizer of Pizza 4-Piece. It's rolling like roll in Vietnam.
That's right. Yeah. It's like a little ricotta kun.
So this is arugula, ham, and ricotta cheese.
I love ricotta. This looks fresh. It looks delicious. Let's try it out. Cheers. So creamy, so clean. The herbs are so fresh and give some flavor too. A little bit of salty ham mixed in.
Yeah.
That's nice. It's very rich. Can you handle the richness? Are you dying for more herbs?
I need some herbs. Yeah,
you need some herbs. No. Right now, I'm excited to be talking to Hugh, head chef at this restaurant right here. How old were you when you first tried cheese? Vietnamese people tend to not like heavy food as much. How could you encourage people to try cheese and become cheese heads like me?
In the world of cheese, especially when making pizza, one cheese stands above the rest.
He will try to convince them at the very beginning, you should try something very light.
It's the cheese Americans eat most, around 11 pounds per year on average.
It's a gateway cheese. They start with that cheese, and before they know it, they're addicted like me, right?
Mozzarella is a type of unripened cheese, meaning it doesn't need to be aged like Parmesan. Here in this factory, they're making over 1,500 individual cheese products per day. It all starts early in the morning, when the factory receives 4 tons of milk. The milk is stored in 2 cooling tanks until nearly 12 hours later at 8 p.m., when the cheese making process begins. Step one, curdling, pumping over 260 gallons of milk into a giant trough used for pasteurization.
Oh, there it is. You got scared.
Pasteurization means bringing the milk to a precise temperature, killing the bad bacteria and keeping the good bacteria.
So we will warm up 2 hours to become 63, then we pasteurize 30 minutes.
When the milk cools down to 104 degrees, they add lactic powder and rennet powder. This combination initiates the curdling process, where solvents bond together, leaving the liquid whey behind. This semi-solid mixture is sliced and diced into smaller pieces with this device known as a plumbus. Working, working, working till the sun comes up. When it's time to drain the liquid, the whey is kept for making ricotta cheese or even beer. Meanwhile, the curd rests in cool water for another couple hours. Step 2, processing the curd. Large chunks of curd are removed from the trough and fed into a cheese kneading machine. This starts to bind the cheese together, altering its physical properties. When the cheese is removed by the cheese specialist, they repeat the same action, stretching and restretching. I'm saving for a rainy day.
It's 6 a.m. We've been making cheese for hours now. The only thing keeping me going is the fact that right now, this lady's making one of my favorite foods ever. The string cheese is made from mozzarella. Not made by machine, but made by hand. But the most important thing is the texture of the cheese.
The more they stretch it, the stringier the cheese will be.
She stretches it out, folds it over, stretches it, and this creates kind of like a cheese grain.
Once it's cut to size, it's ready to eat.
Look at the way this unraveled. Oh my lord. That is what we're looking for. Oh, it's so good. Delicious, rich mozzarella. Not too salty. Very clean. Obviously fresh. Nice. We're getting down to cheesy business over here. We're balling up this mozzarella. It's really hot. So one pair of gloves is not gonna do it. Ready. This gentleman is stretching out the cheese. It gets rotated, rotated, rotated. And then you just kind of squeeze out a portion and you just pinch it off. When there's a new one, can I try it? If this shows up on one of your pizzas, it's fine, right?
It looks like mochi.
It looks like mochi. All right, should I put it in here? Oh, it feels nice. Oh, the mozzarella. It is my wish to eat a ball of mozzarella like an apple. Can I do that?
Sure.
Really?
Yes.
Take a look, guys. Oh, it's still warm. It's like a giant marshmallow. Try not to cry. It's like the best moment of my life. It's got this squeaky texture that only some of the best cheese can have. I'm amazed that this was milk just a few hours ago. Mm. And already it's just this beautiful, melty, stretchy mozzarella. It's glorious. I think I just ate like 500 calories.
Now it's early morning and a large shipment of mozzarella is ready to be delivered immediately to their restaurants.
Here it is. We have a little bit of tomato, mozzarella on top, a basil leaf on top of that. It's all soaked in salt and pepper and a bit of olive oil.
Yeah.
Let's try it out. Oh, I'm in love. The cheese has so much body and the salt brings out some of the flavor of the cheese. And then just the flavor coming from the basil, from the oil, salt and pepper. I love it.
And I think the taste make you like feel better for your next main course, right?
Right. It just gets you ready and excited for more cheese.
Alas, it's time for the king of cheesed dishes. The pizza. Here, the menu ranges from the familiar.
This looks glorious.
To Japanese-inspired creations you have never seen before.
Here, the five cheese pizza, all cheeses that they make here in their factory. They've also put blue cheese, but it's blended.
Yeah.
Everything is made from scratch with absolute precision. The dough is kneaded, then spread out until it reaches 11 inches. They add what they call milky sauce, then mozzarella, camembert, blue cheese, taleggio, parmesan, and a hit of olive oil. It bakes for exactly 80 seconds in a brick oven, served with a small vessel of honey on the side.
You have never had blue cheese.
Yeah.
Oh my God, this is fantastic.
Is it too much for the beginner like me?
No,
no?
It's perfect. All right, try it out. How do you feel? You're making a lot of sounds.
Salty, but not too bad.
Not too bad. That's a really high compliment. Here, because this has a sharp flavor, we've got some honey to kind of create some balance. It's super cheesy. This is an ideal pizza for like, girlfriend breaks up with me. She doesn't want to talk to me, which I know is going to lead to a breakup. And then I order this, and I eat my emotions. I feel better for at least an hour. Yeah. You don't do that?
No.
Oh, that's why you're so thin. Yeah. Here, one of the most unique pizzas they serve here. This is a sashimi pizza.
The dough is prepared a little differently. It's baked in the oven for 80 seconds with a mixture of olive oil and shredded parmesan on top. Then they evenly spread a sauce of capers and ricotta cheese. Sprinkle a bit of minced onion, then the raw salmon.
It doesn't get you high, but it smells good. What? It reminds me of bagels and lox. It's taken the form of a pizza. Nice, properly cooked bread, some creamy dairy, and some salmon.
It's really good. I am addicted to it.
That's right. While it's in your mouth, you feel like a good person. Yeah, that's the drug.
We have one last pizza in store, an Italian-inspired pie that can't be made without one unique ingredient, burrata. This stuff makes me feel fancy. and it stands in stark contrast to more mediocre processed cheeses. But I'll let you in on a secret.
Here, they're making burrata. Ooh, what's that?
Burrata is a fresh cream inside of the mozzarella.
Similar to what we saw before, he's doing the same thing. He's kind of making the ball, and then that ball comes over here. They kind of hollow out the ball like they're making a little clay bowl. Then they dip it into this cream or liquid cheese, or what's that?
The fresh cream.
At first, they flatten and stretch the mozzarella cheese to create a stringy texture. Then shred it. Mix it with whipping cream. That becomes the filling.
Like some hakau. They kind of crimp it together on top. You know hakau?
No, I don't know hakau.
No? The best part is they tie it shut using more cheese. So everything is edible. The experience of eating burrata compared to mozzarella, how is it different?
It's more gorgeous, dynamic, like mild.
And now I'm back from the factory.
I never had the pizza with the huge burrata cheese in it like this.
The pizza crust is topped with a layer of arugula leaves.
You don't put any sauce in it?
No. You want chili sauce right now so bad, don't you?
Generous portions of Parma ham, cherry tomatoes.
You're actually supposed to be cutting the cheese.
And finally, the burrata.
Oh, are we getting a close-up of that? So when we look inside, it is interesting. It's like a cheese shell covered with more creamy cheese. Let's try it out. Oishii. The arugula is kind of fragrant and light. There's some nice salty ham, and then the cheese itself is just really like cold and creamy.
For anyone that wants to try cheese for the first time, burrata is very easy to eat, like it's not too sweet.
The cheese it does have is super fresh, super clean. I like it.
Cheese is a guilty pleasure to most Americans. And no one. These days, it tops, smothers, or is injected into nearly everything.
You know, Vietnam is not a country that's known for its love of cheese. Did that freak you out? Did you know that when you started a pizza restaurant here?
The trend in Asia was slow to emerge.
So first 2 years, maybe almost 100% are foreigners, but now it's 75% are Vietnamese, local Vietnamese.
Now, with more local factories and suppliers flooding the market, it's safe to say the cheese train is chugging along and gaining speed. From researching and shooting to editing and mastering, our 10-person Best Ever Food Review Show team works hard to roll out the highest quality travel food entertainment twice a week. If you like what we do here, please consider supporting our Patreon. Patreon allows fans of the show to contribute a monthly sum and receive a load of extras like early video releases, private Q&As, and beyond.
To learn more about our Patreon, check out the link in the description box down below. And if you can't give or don't even feel like it, that's okay too. We're just happy you're here. Guys, thank you so much for watching. A huge thank you to Han with her own YouTube channel, Han Around. Go check her out. She's doing wine reviews and soon to come, so much more. That is it for this one. Thank you so much for watching. We will see you next time. A peace. Good. And no one makes me feel like you know.